Like the chimney stack, the reason it turned out like that is it sort of reminds me of the chimneys that were built in 1870s, and there ain't many left, you know, they've nearly always had the tops ripped off, and you just get the odd one here and there. And it's like a sort of memorial to when I've gone, you know, people will think, you know, that's a very unusual chimney stack there, you know, it ain't got a chimney pot on like everybody else's, you know. So I suppose you could say in lots of ways it's a memorial to, you know, the great age of steam and Lancashire and boilers and spinning mills and me, I suppose.
That's it. Do
you think we'll get it off him, won't you?
I don't know. I'll have a word with him. I'll probably see him tonight anyway. I'm doing a job for this guy here.
Yeah.
When I came up last time, I spotted it in the garden. Yeah. I didn't say anything to him then.
Yeah.
But that's the one. It's perfect.
Yeah, it'll be just right. Proportions, won't it, for top of gear blend?
You could do with two of them, really. Well, there's another one somewhere.
Yeah. You think we can get it off him?
Oh, I think so, because I know the guy who owns this place.
Yeah.
And he's a teacher, you see.
Yeah.
And I know that he mentioned he liked to bring the kids down to your yard to see the engine, you see. So if I can work a deal in, that if he brings the kids down, if feel that you have his stone ball, then sort of payment, if you like.
Yeah, I'm game with me, isn't it? Get steam up, let kids have a look at the engine, and we'll have his stone ball. I mean, it's not really doing out there, is it? You come home drunk, you'd fall over it, wouldn't you? Get the blocks. All right, don't strain yourself, it'll be all right. Right, Ronnie. Yeah. Oh. Yeah. It's quite a fearsome thing, isn't it? Keep pulling, fellas. Look, the branch, it'd be hard luck if the bloody branch broke off the tree now, wouldn't it? Keep going. Right.
Okay.
Yeah. This is where the Tarzan act comes in, eh? Hey.
Oh. Right.
Right, you're all right, let go. Mustn't go through these gaps. Right.
I'll give him a lift now.
It's safe enough, this scaffold. It's a bit shaky, but it won't collapse. Oh, no, be careful, Billy. Hang on to the pipes, not the plank. Beautiful. Right. Next job, get this off.
Yeah.
Right.
That's it.
Yeah, I've got it.
No.
This is the one.
Right, then. Yeah. You right, Fred?
Yeah. Keep going.
Bit more.
Got it. Right.
You all got it on that.
Yeah.
On that pin.
Oh, wait a minute. We might all end up with big what's this, have you?
Yeah. So right. That's it.
How's that?
Superb.
Yeah.
How's it look?
Looks all right from up here.
It's terrific, isn't it?
Yeah, a lot better than the other thing. Let's go downstairs and have a, you know, have a view
across the road.
Yeah. Don't think it'll blow away as easy, will it? The oil can's been upside down again.
Yeah, just wipe some.
No!
stick blower on, Les, because we've only got about an hour and we've only got £25 on.
Mostly
VIPs and customers. Yeah. And they'll start to arrive, what, about 11:30? Yeah. We'll
get them in there, give them a drink.
Yeah.
If it stays like this, we can get them out here.
Yeah.
Taking a drink, just watching
what's happening here. And you're having a young lady, aren't you, sat over there?
She'll be sat over there, yeah.
Are you well in tune? Yes. Nothing to do now, only wait. Is the bar open? You should have a martini. Ciao.
Fred, turn this way. Turn this way, lad.
Thank you.
Okay, lovely play.
Hey, that was brilliant.
Yeah.
Oh, you liked it.
Well, yeah. I loved it. Because I'd love to do it one of those.
You'd like to smash it to bloody pieces. These people get unbelievable ideas, you know, about promoting the products. Like, the phone rung one day and they said, would you like to come to Old Trafford and run over a computer? I said, yeah, well, if you'll pay me. That's how we ended up here. I like doing my own thing, like, you know, the steam job and all of that, and if they can work it in with their modern lives, it doesn't bother me at all. Well, some things are rather stupid that they ask you to do, and I feel embarrassed about it, and I don't really want to do it, you know. I mean, people have said to me, like, well, you look right out of place when you were doing that, and I've actually felt right out of place while I've been doing it. Like, bloody glamorous grandmother competition. What the hell do I know about glamorous grandmothers, you know, like? not really my scene. I don't think they like me. Yeah, I don't think they like me, cats. Get stuck in.
Okay, let's have it looking nice and happy.
The cat's not happy.
The cat's not happy.
Meow! 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 Meow!
Meow!
Meow!
Meow! Meow! Meow! Meow! Meow!
Meow! Meow! Meow! Meow! Meow! Meow! Meow!
Meow! Meow! Meow! Meow! Meow! Meow! Meow! Meow! Meow! Meow!
Meow! Meow! Meow! Meow! Meow! What is your
interest, mate? Well, we've got one at home, you know, sort of style. Since I've been married, we've had about four cats, and three of them have come to grief. First, somebody shot it. The next, got poisoned and just faded away. And then the next one, I think that it just became ill. The wife took it to vets and spent 15 quid on the damn thing, brought it back, and it was dead 10 minutes later. So I told it to take the bloody pills back.
which he did. 15 quid and it were dead 10 minutes later.
These paintings have been done by children from local schools, and we'd like you to judge first, second and third in each section.
I shouldn't be good at that. I used to go to that at school.
Did you?
I like that parrot.
The budget.
Yeah, bud, no, we'll have that one for this prize.
Right.
This one.
Blair Whitaker.
Yeah. That's a nice face, though.
Cheers, Dan, darling. She's beautiful, Kat.
My knowledge of pussycats isn't very great, and the only experience I've had with them is having one wandering about on top of a 160-foot tall factory chimney. You know? Yeah. The RSPCA man, he's got a big, beautiful plastic basket. We tied four pieces of string on it and filled it up with cat meat. And I'm back up the chimney again with a basket at the side of the cat. But there's no way to go in, and I don't think cats really like me. It wouldn't go in. And a man came out of the crowd and he said, "We have a man here who is from the animals in distress, and he's very good at catching cats in high places," you see. The manager, poor fella, since had an heart attack and died, said, "We don't want no bloody heroes, get him out of place," you see. So that was the end of him, as we thought. The thing is that when everybody went home for lunch, he had to do on his own. And when we arrived back from lunch, the Black Mariah's there, the ambulance is there, he's at the top of the chimney, he's got the cat, but he's stuck. He's got the cat in one hand and clinging onto the ladder with the other, you see. So up the ladders I went. And I said, "Look, cop, if you do what I tell you to do with your legs, you'll be able to leave go. So you got the cat with both hands." And I went down first. He came down. Bloody police arrested him, you know, I never saw him again.
Next week, Fred undertakes the not-too-familiar task of felling a tower. That's at the same time, 8:30.